Chai! Now, wow! People we supposed to talk through to power down off mic. And if we talk, now 500,000 they go summon us, call them hate speech. But fear not, my ego don't come. Ingo torchlight every corner, nooks and cranny of all these bad, bad people where they spoil our country.
Deceiving the rest of the country. How is that economically viable? I don't know what transaction that Nigeria is currently having on, having with Niger Republic that is better than what economic sense it would make to build a rail, to build a train line from Lagos, linking, even if you are going to link from Kano to Calabar to the seaport, to open up the seaport for people who want to move their own cargoes from Calabar on a port and move them to the heartland of the eastern Nigeria, the congested Lagos, spend that $2 billion to build a rail line to where you have been milking for years, for decades. And you can actually make more if you are economically sensible. But they are not. That's now completely gives credence to those who are telling you that if you are not smart, before you know it, that little thing you are clinging on to as my country, our town, our village, our land, all of them will soon be gone. You will be gone, because as you think you have something to lose, what do you even have to lose not being part of Nigeria in the first place? I mean, what have you gained for being part of Nigeria as we speak? So you share in the mystery, and the mystery of this time around is that Niger Republic is now the 37th state of Nigeria. Some of you just don't know the clue yet. For 5 years, before they came in, we knew then that some of your refineries were working like half dead, half alive for this period. They are dead completely now. And they were supposed to be revived by a dead Bokuwari. But what happened? Everything it touched dies. And that is Nigeria. But they are not stupid not to build fortress elsewhere. Niger Republic. You are likely to be the stupid one who is not seeing that. How is constructing $2 billion rail line from Kano State to Niger Republic is economically beneficial to Nigeria, other than God knows what that intention was, is, but Nigeria will pay for it. And they are doing this because I think I was reading that, it was the last year, because it's now 2021, when the Minister of State for Petroleum, the former governor of Bayelsa State, was celebrating the milestone, the victory, that Nigeria will begin to import fuel from Niger Republic, since Nigeria is going to remove subsidy. So they decided to go and develop refineries that will only give them 20,000 barrels of oil a day, when they left those that can give them over 1 million barrels a day in Nigeria, because that is not economic viable for them, for their greed, except for Niger Republic. We have also read that how much so many northern state governors, politicians, have also invested in so many parts of the economy of Niger State using Nigeria money. They have invested in their politicians. They have invested in their, in their communities. They have invested in so many ways. Investing, when I say invest, sending money from Nigeria to initiate serious, bigger projects in different communities in Niger Republic, because they see it as a commitment, something that some of you are possibly not seeing or not paying attention to. Then that takes me to Oyo. Someone said, Mayegun, is Oyo State going to be the new Borno State, or our own Borno State in Yoruba land? I'm like, my brother, You can call it anything. Yoruba land is going to begin to experience the worst of the insecurity ever. This is not a curse. This is not wishing my land the evil happening elsewhere. It is actually a clarion call to let you know that the same way you are not paying attention to how much effort, energy, investment they are putting into destroying that Nigeria that you think you have a stake in. As much as you're not paying that attention, you're likely not paying attention to the same thing going on around you. And we can take Oyo State as an example. It is now yam, pepper, scatter in Oyo State as we speak. It has become a political landmine that everyone is now being careful of what to say, when to say it, where to say it in Yoruba land. Yes, that is the situation too. The Northern Nigeria, which I want to agree, I actually agree, is not monolithic. We are doing injustice to them. Every time we call them Northern Nigeria, because there are people who are actually there. They are placed in the north based on the drawing of the map. But you cannot say, when they say Northern Muslims, everyone there is a Muslim. No, look at what they are doing to Father Kuka today. People are dying. Some people choose to bury that, pretend that, well, since it's not us. Who are those they are killing? Oh, they are killing Benue, people from that's not that doesn't really matter. Oh, they kill people also, some people from this village. Who are they? Oh, they don't really matter. Don't worry, that's not a big thing. Oh, they bomb a mosque. Hey, they bombed the mosque. Why would they do that? Okay, you know what? Let's see people who can frame up for that. It doesn't really matter because they are not monolithic, they are not one. There are many north, just same way there is no one Nigeria. There are many Nigerias. And you have the right to choose if you want to be a Nigeria, a Nigerian, or you want to actually hug your own identity with passion. Hug your identity. Be proud of who you are. The same way in Yoruba land, we are not monolithic Yorubas. Someone sent me a very powerful message that I managed to read this time around. And it was very, very, very explanatory. He said, Mayegun, you are an Ijebu man. I am I'm a Kiti man. We have Egbas. We have so many Yorubas. But it is easier because of how, or should I say, because of for semantic's sake, when people say we are Yorubas, one Yorubas, there are many. But there are some things that can always make you one, which Yorubas, Igbos, the Hausas, the Fulanis, the Ijaws, the Shekiris, everyone from every tribe can easily do or identify with. That is the language. And that is also something that Nigeria, when you try to put and force Nigeria together, right, does not have. One language, one thing that can make everybody one. So when they keep on doing what they are doing to divide and destroy Nigeria, what will be left for you will be your own identity, the identity of who you are. Embrace it, find your brother, your sisters, guide your mind, your lands, protect yourselves, and that will be what it will all come to. So you may pretend now, because of your political affiliations or associations, your religious association, and so many other things that makes you think everything we are telling you about Nigeria is exaggerated. But there will be something left. It will be your real identity, the one you are struggling and struggling to accept, embrace, the same way you have been deceived to embrace that one Nigeria. Those in charge of one Nigeria, past, present, and future, they are not there because of you. And this is one of the pointers. There are pointers to prove to you that the longer you hold on to one Nigeria, the farther and farther you are deceiving and destroying yourself. Your identity will come to this. So I'm going to still speak more on the why Yoruba is not also monolithic, but there will be something uniting us. It is the language, which, to God be the glory, is linked to our Oduduwa heritage. There are many stories around that. But let's come back to what Nigeria has done to you and the danger you are in. If you ignore all these pointers, all these red flags, that Nigeria is not for you, no matter how much you believe in it, no matter how much you have invested in it, you are probably alone. In Yoruba land, we saw the news. They said Amotekun is now walking. In fact, Amotekun is walking because they have Meyetiala as stakeholders. In Yoruba land, reports came that a part of four local governments in Oyo State, four local government areas, are hotbeds for terrorists, which the governor of the state came out to alert the whole world, right? Four local governments. So Amotekun, they were reported to have swung into action, decided to raid and sweep the area of all manners of bandits and terrorists who are kidnapping, raping, terrorizing, destroying farms of our own people in Yoruba land. That was the news, until 2 days later. So the report came that in the course of that engagement, right, Amotekun succeeded in sweeping many of them out of about three local governments except one, where they got engaged and they were shot at by Fulani bandits. That is also the news. Afterward, the report also came that not just that they killed seven bandits, they also arrested 46 of them. Oh, great. So what was going to happen? Prosecute them. No, we can't really prosecute them. We have to hand them over to the police. Okay. Then a day after that, story changed. That is where the political landmine I am talking about. You may live in denial. It is your right. Enjoy it. There are people who have lived in denial in the past, but they are not living in that denial anymore. You will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Think about that. It is now a political landmine in your state. A day after that, arrested bandits shooting at Amotekun soldiers. Then Amotekun overpowered them, killed seven, arrested 46. The story changed. They said they were not bandits. In fact, they are Fulani vigilantes. What the hell? Fulani vigilantes, what? In Yoruba land? On whose authority? Well, on the authority of Meyetiala. Really? The same Meyetiala that is now a negotiator between the federal government and Fulani terrorists, bandits, and Boko Haram. The same Meyetiala are now the one providing security for us in Oyo State. Really? Seyi Makinde, did you know about this? No. No idea. Just hearing that for the first time. Hey, Commissioner of Police, do you know about this? No. Amotekun, do you know about this? Hey, they are stakeholders. Really? Stakeholders in security of Yoruba land. And it took you the operation of sweeping an area reported to be under the siege of terrorists for you to find out. Wow. That's the story as we speak. So if you are a Yoruba man watching me right now, you are going to agree with me someday, soon, that what you are denying, like many other people who are also pretending that, since it's not happening to them, yes, it's happening in the northern area. It's not me. It's isolated until it became what it is today. You are going to come back to agree with me that Yoruba land is in soup. Soup that is waiting to play out. In Yoruba land right now, many, many people are more interested in 2023. Great. But we will continue to remind you, if you are looking forward to elect people who are going to supervise and govern over graveyards, go to Benue State. They have something they will report about democracy when this whole drama finally comes to an end. It will be the graves of those armless civilians, people, villagers, ordinary people that were killed by terrorists that will never be prosecuted, by terrorists that will never, ever face justice. Their thumbs, their graveyards line the states, Benue State, and many, many other states, for those who are keeping their dead, burying their dead slowly and quietly. Yoruba land. Are you sure we are going to be able to handle that? Because the following day, they said, bandits, arrested bandits with guns. They are no longer bandits. In fact, they are helping you and me to keep us safe. And the area they are protecting people, to protect the citizen, to protect you and me, eh? They are the areas where kidnappings, attacks on farmers, killings. This morning, there's a news that came on about a young man killed in Osun State. Let me see if I can pick up the story. And I can, his name is Razak, right? So they killed him because he had, a face-off with a Fulani terrorist in Osun last year. So they attacked his farm, they fought back, pushed them back, and that led to a serious wahala then. So this time around, they came back this year, and they went for him, right? They killed him, long story short. They killed him yesterday. And the villagers, the young people there, they managed to arrest the killers. They arrested two of them. And guess what? They have to hand them over to the police. So Miyet Yala, they have threatened the whole country, including Yoruba land, that if we fail to give them Ruga, if we fail to give them land for Ruga, we will face the consequences of that. And in return of that, they gave Miyet Yala Vigilante access to Yoruba land last year or 2 years ago before the election. We caught some of them with their ID card and their guns and their cattle. They said they are Miyet Yala Vigilantes in Yoruba land, Ondo State. Today, Ondo State is under siege. But because the governor of Ondo State is APC member, they will underplay it and they will watch their people die, get killed, as they are doing right now. But it's on you to what? To do the right thing. Someone said, what should we do, Mayegun? I told somebody, I said, if you really want to save Yoruba land, if you really want to help Yoruba land, you have to dislodge all the criminals who are currently parading themselves as Yoruba leaders, past and present, and any of them who is attempting to call, attempting to represent you in the Project Nigeria. Their job is to protect themselves, make so much money they can make from the system, and watch you get killed. Like a story I'm about to share with you now. This story belongs to the Punch newspaper, and I want you to watch the interview to the end. Listen to the sad voices of these guys who were killed, and nothing will happen in Yoruba land because you have Miyet Yala having a hold on all the political criminals in Yoruba land, PDP, APC. They have the capacity to unleash terror wherever they want to. And it seems Oyo State is going to be a theater of that absurdity. Seyi Makinde will have to live up to it. They are forcing him, they are pressurizing him now to release those 46 bandits because they have also launched media war on Amotekun, especially Amotekun in Oyo State. You may have started reading a lot about Amotekun here and there. There are things launched to make sure that in another few weeks, if things like this continue, they are going to tell you that Amotekun is disbanded. They will arrest all their leaders and we'll go fully into the new chapter of what we have been telling you. Nigeria is made to destroy you. As long as you belong to that Nigeria, you will never have any reason to escape all these absurdities. And for those who are representing Yoruba land, making the deals on behalf of Yoruba land, right? They are making the worst deals. They are agreeing to the worst deals on behalf of Yoruba people. Project Nigeria should be project of a republic whereby you have a stake, not one politician or some group of lunatics parading themselves as politicians. You, the people who give that power to those politicians, you should have a stake if Nigeria was indeed a republic. But Nigeria is not a republic, so you have no say. So you need to change them. The drive should be how to change those who speak for Yoruba. I'm not talking about the social groups alone, including the political group.